Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player. Good day. Ira Epstein with your agriculture update, and I am late. It's 5:10 p.m. Central Standard Time on this Thursday, November 16th, 2017. We are building a whole new website, and as we're building it, and I'm getting files ready, and my IT people are doing most of the work, we're just getting buried in things. Over the weekend, we will launch the new website. So if you're a regular viewer, you go to our site for anything, you'll see a complete new look to it. Will everything work at one time? Who knows? You know how links go on those things, but we're trying. The corn and the wheat and the soybeans are not open yet. They open at 7 p.m. Central Standard Time. It was a mixed day in them today. The cotton market had a small rally, as did the sugar. And now we're open in a number of the other markets, as you can see. What is weighing on the financial markets, not so much the agriculture markets, are the tax bills and how they're going. We saw the House of Representatives had a positive vote, so that's going to move on. Now the question is the Senate. Can they get it out of a committee, then to the Senate vote, and then we'll know what we've got. So in looking at everything right now in the soybeans, we continue to be down. For the week, we're down on the chart 5.25 cents, falling back toward support at this 18-week moving average of closes. When we come to a daily area chart of closes, it is still very much in the down thrust mode, having fallen about 25 cents from its peak, and the market still not showing a bounce where it wants to get back up to that 18-day moving average of closes. When we take a look at a daily bar chart, there's just nothing pretty on this chart. This market broke hard from last week when we got the supply-demand report, and it showed more yield per acre, not as much demand for the products, and basically its weight on the market as it's come down. You have a pattern of a higher high, you see that, and a lower low. That is not a trend. The market, if it rallies, should encounter, I don't know that it will or won't, but it should encounter resistance between the 100-day average of 982 and 985.5, the 18-day average of closes. The support's coming in from the lower Bollinger Band, but it's the type of support that you have to be suspect of because it doesn't back away from that lower band. If the market decides to move with a thrust to the downside, you'll ride that band for a bit, and that's when things get ugly. In terms of momentum, you are oversold. So what we have, I think, is a pause in a market looking for the next direction. The bias is down and the market is oversold, and it has hit some support areas. I'm moving away from now the December meal into the Jan meal. So I see a pattern of lower highs, lower lows. Again, we have that very tight Bollinger Band and a market that is oversold, but that oversold could switch to embedded. Take a look at both these numbers. They're both under 20 today. Yesterday, both numbers were under 20 and the day before. So you have what's called an embedded reading. In order for this market to lose its bearishness, this red line has to close over 20, which tells me that I think the pros will sell this market on rallies back to that 18-day average of closes until that pattern is lost. I've also moved you on to the January soybean oil, and as you can see, you have a pattern of a higher high and a lower low. Oil's the wild card here since we put on tariff increases into Argentina and Indonesia, so now the U.S. has to make up with its beans that difference. If this market comes down again and takes out especially 34.15, that would give you the lower highs, lower lows. But what if it doesn't take out 34.15? In all fairness, all the market has to do tomorrow is close lower, not take out today's highs, and you'll have a pattern of a lower high and a lower low. So this market is knocking on the door of turning down. The corn market, remember what I just said about beans, how it's riding that lower Bollinger Band? This is what I mean. And when you get an embedded reading, they grab hold and they feed on that until there's a reason no longer to feed on the bearishness. So I'm viewing this market as very bearish. I view this whole sideways action as a top
that is carrying the market lower. I'm well aware that at any time you can see farmers shut off their selling or people will say there's more demand, blah, blah, blah. I'm a chartist. Take the name off the chart and that's just a darn bearish signal until it isn't anymore. In the wheat market, I've moved you on now to the March wheat. Lower highs, lower lows, momentum down, under the 18-day average. I still look for this market to be working lower. You'd have to get up and close over. First, you'd have to got 446 and a quarter, the last high, and then close over the 18-day average to convince me that you don't have anything that's still bearish. You cannot turn this trend as it sits right now from bear to bull. You can easily keep the bear trend. In the sugar market, we look back and I think what we saw was, as we were talking together here, this turned out to be the base. The market is making new highs after both the bullish crossover where the 18 went over the 100-day and you have your embedded reading. Until it's over, it ain't over, and this market's still looking bullish. Coffee is without trend. You have an overbought market. It's hit the upper Bollinger Band and in the process made a higher high and then broke right down. So you got higher high, lower low, sort of just playing around this 18-day average in an overbought market. The cocoa market, you've got a pattern of higher lows and higher highs. So after this big run-up where they didn't think they had enough cocoa and the buyers came out, and I'm talking cash buyers rather aggressively, you've pulled back here. If this market's going to stay bullish, the battleground should be this 18-day average, and at this pattern, you should not get under 2110. So I will not be surprised to see the bulls make a stand against that number at this point. In the cotton market, you got up to the upper Bollinger Band and you hit a brick wall again. That's so often the case, and that is because markets will trade within these black dash bands 95% of the time. Support's back down at the 18-day average. Momentum is fairly flat right here, and you have a pattern of lower highs, lower lows over the 18-day average of closes. Not much to say. Cattle market, you tried to bounce yesterday, you gave that back today, you're still in an oversold condition and in a market that has fallen very hard. If this market's good, one of the things it should not do is take out yesterday's lows, because you could end up now with a pattern of higher low, higher high because of that. Take out this low and you probably are setting up a challenge of whatever that Bollinger Band turns out to be. You're in a downtrend in the feeder cattle with the lower highs, lower lows, but you are oversold, have not yet hit the lower Bollinger Band. Will you is going to be the big question that traders ask. And in the hog market, you're down to the 100-day average and the lower Bollinger Band in a market that has got smacked down from right up here near the 73-cent mark, about 700 points, quite a break in that market. Want to remind you, I write a lot about all this, and if you'd like to find out what I do, here's how I start off my day. You start off with a cup of coffee, you see it in the background there, and then I review 40 charts at a time for you. In those charts, I do review all the agriculture markets and the like, the soft commodities, the meats, give you an idea of what I'm seeing, and I do wait until 8:30 a.m. Central Standard Time to do the recording, so you get to see the opening of the grain market, the options, what all's going on. I talk about the market, throw out plenty of ideas. I write twice a day on average about the market, send it out to you as a synopsis of what's making the markets move, along with very specific buy here, sell there ideas. If you'd like to get a free trial to this, if you haven't tried it, give us a call, 866-973-2077. You can go to our website, www.iraepstein.com. Or you can click up here if you're watching me on YouTube or underneath us on any of the websites that carry this is just a video. They typically say, click here for Ira's free information. I'm Ira Epstein. You have a great day, and I will talk to you all tomorrow.